What a wonderful way to start being back in Bangalore with that yummy, yummy vegetarian breakfast. We're well filled, and now Rocky has a plan for us.
I had an uncle once who said, when you finish breakfast, remember it is time for lunch. And keeping him in mind, we are standing here on a road that honors his name. This is the Bordillon Road. And every time Uncle Dylan was bored, we used to call him Bordillon, which is very relevant in some strange way. As Uncle Dylan turns over in his grave, let me tell you that we are at the Alibaba Cafe and Restaurant. This place is famous for the Bhatkalli cuisine, which we're going to try out and tell you more about.
What we know so far of the Bhatkalli cuisine is that when the Arab traders used to come to this part of the world, and the people here combined the Arab tastes and the Arab food, along with food from here, and out of that came the Bhatkalli cuisine, the Bhatkalli community.
A good way to find out how the food is to ask the people around, and these people who are obviously locals from Bangalore seem to be the only ones over here. Hi, how are you guys?
Locals from today.
Locals from today onwards.
There you go.
How's the food? Have you guys finished or are you waiting to start?
We had the best food.
To tell us a little bit more about what Bhatkalli cuisine is, basically to prove that I'm right, we're with the owner of Alibaba, Sain Damodi.
Bhatkalli cuisine is nothing but cuisine in and around the Bhatka, which is in the west coast of Karnataka. It's mainly of the spices that which are made, we have specially made actually over there.
And this is a sort of Arabic influence food.
Yeah, a little bit.
That's the best way to describe it.
What are the dishes that you would recommend here?
For vegetarian, dosha milk, nothing but a pickle.
I know I'm vegetarian, we don't usually eat as much as meat eaters. But just pickle is not going to do it. Do you have more?
And alipe, which is a wild mushroom. It's made, you get during the rainy season. It's a seasonal actually. You can keep it for some time.
Wonderful. But once you keep it, does it not become tame mushroom?
No, it doesn't.
Still wild.
Still wild.
There's something typically Bhatkalli that you do that is sort of...
You can try...
dish kind of thing.
You can try shayya biryani.
Shayya biryani?
Look, in Bhatkal, the typical dish you'll find is biryanis actually.
I'm going to run through the names of the dishes, and Ali, please tell me if I'm right now. This is Sheesh Tok.
Yeah, exactly.
This is Sheesh Bhaktiari. This is Suke Mas.
Yeah.
And this is Lawn Miri
Mas.
Alright, Lawn Miri as in the salt and chili mutton. That is called the Shayya Biryani, the famous noodle biryani that I've never tried before.
The vegetarians have this paneer that we're all familiar with. It's called Sheesh Kuddar. And this is called Mirza Ghazmi.
This is the sawwa poli or the rice roti. It goes very well with this cuisine. And now we've got these three wonderful drinks over here. This one is my favorite. It's a Saudi champagne. It's a mixture of lemonade, apple juice, and it's fizzy and it's sweet and it's delicious.
What I've got is a cucumber juice concoction, believe it or not. It's a Bhatkalli mocktail.
Thanks a lot, Ali, for helping out.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay.
Ali's left, but we have the alipe. This is the wild mushroom dish, and this is a Bhatkalli speciality. These are almost like button mushrooms. And it's got a lot of onion and spices, and the mushrooms add a little chewy texture to it. Very, very tasty.
The Sheesh Bhaktiari is a combination of mutton and chicken. I will say though, this is a really authentic Middle Eastern taste.
The karang fry is quite interesting. Essentially sliced off pieces of sweet potato and then deep fried it with spice in it, put some masala on top. So it's a nice combination of sweet and quite spicy.
The shish tuk is very authentic. Once again, that Middle Eastern taste, which a lot of places try and get, but almost always get wrong. The good news is that Alibaba's got it right.
The Mirza Ghazmi is purely exotic. It's got aubergines and then they mix it with chili and garlic. Come out a very nice strong taste. Closest I can think of that it would come to is it's a spicier cousin of the baba ganoush.
Now for the shayya biryani. This one is truly unique. So I got us lots of noodles over here with what looks like fried onions on top of them. Oh wow, and there's some mutton pieces underneath. That's incredibly unique. The noodles have this strange texture, and as for a biryani, it's quite standard. It has the dry fruits, the Elaichi, I can taste the cinnamon and the long. It's really different in terms of the texture.
This is dessert. This is called the shofa pana pudding. It's sweet, and it's got some cream on top, and it's a taste of something that I can't identify. Help!
Let me put my expert taste buds to the test. I can taste dill leaves. There's dill leaves in here. And it's caramelized at the bottom, and it's got a little nice jammy kind of sweet syrup on top of it, along with some cream. That's what it's made of.
Isn't he amazing? Remember, a true expert always knows to how to ask somebody off camera so that he can share exactly what it is. I'm
Don't give away all our secrets. Time for Rocky and Mayur's report card. Taste.
7.
8. Ambience.
8.
8.
Service.
9.
9. And value for money?
9.
7.
Bhatkalli cuisine has proved to be different from anything that you ever had before. So you should need to get down over here and check it out because it is quite good. Very familiar on the palate and yet a little foreign.
After this, we take you somewhere where we can finally answer the question of what came first, the chicken or the egg. And it was neither, it was a factory.